One of our fee growth challenges in the U.S. is the aging of our client base, and they're getting to a point where they're 60 and 70 years old, no children in the business, and it's become time for them to cash out. And when they do that, it's great for them, and hopefully an opportunity for us on our wealth management business, but it's the loss of an accounting and tax client who's often been with us for a very long time. Yes, and we've probably had about a dozen of these situations in our client base within the last 12 months.
The increased competition for clients has made fee pressure and a very big issue, and has led to some loss of clients.
Fee pressure, which I hear commonly is an issue. Who else do we have, please?
Just efficiently managing our sales pipeline and having good visibility on who our prospects are and how we're converting them and what it costs us from identification through to conversion.
So opportunity cost?
I'm not sure if it's an opportunity cost, but it's just managing our sales pipeline.
Okay.
So we've got a CRM tool, we've got it populated with clients, and you know, how do we efficiently manage those prospects and convert them to clients?
Okay.
We're an 8-partner firm, one partner 63, and the other 7 partners in the 50s. So my problem is the potential complacency of older partners and lack of hunger of older partners.
Yes.
I mean, the marketing's fine, and we bring in leads, and that's working, but it's actually getting off the backsides and going out there and winning business.
Right. Thank you. And we all have that. Recurring fee apathy is a term I use for this, that we are somewhat spoiled in the profession, in that we do not have to hunt and kill each month in order for us to be able to make our payrolls and pay ourselves whatever we would like to pay ourselves. It is far more relaxed than that. From a forecasting point of view, it is far more easy to know where next year's business is coming from than for many of our clients.